month is Black History Month. And we're celebrating the contributions that black people and people of color have contributed to America. See, every time when I was coming up as a young lad, they didn't teach nothing about what black folks done. Only thing that you knew what black folks done was hanging from a tree or swinging half naked in a jungle. That's all you seen when I was coming up. But now we have more information on the accomplishments that we have done. I knew nothing about George Washington Carver. I knew nothing about Brother Latimer. Didn't know none of that. Only thing I knew was Dr. Martin Luther King. But for anything that your people have contributed to this nation, it just wasn't there when I was coming up. And when you don't know stuff, you can develop self-hatred, hatred toward your skin color and your texture of hair. Well, that was one of the main that was one of the main teachings that Europeans did to black people, was to divide us up. Y'all know the story about Willie Lynch, don't you? Instead of hanging black folk, black men, because you all such valuable stock, then you inbreed them and divide them up by skin color. Hey, black people are nine shades of brown. We come all the way from blue, black, brown, yellow, and tan, and caramel color. We all different colors.
Yep.
So he said divide them up by skin color, texture, hair, height, and age. And you know what? He said if you do this, it'll stay with black folk for anywhere from 400 to 1,000 years. Black people, you ought to welcome the second coming of Christ. Because in America, racism is still bad. I can say that.
Jesus, Pastor.
I can say that because you all not have experienced it, but you are experiencing it right now.
Yes.
Sometimes racism can come by you having a black boss over you. When the slave master got ready to whoop a Negro's behind for running away, who did he get to whooping? Some big black Negro with a whip on the plantation. That even developed more hate. You're a whooping boy. Well, we're trying to bring out truths of black history. You know, of all the churches I've been to, and all the material that I've read, black people are totally, what can I say, you're not even included. You're omitted. Part of the problem with young black men is that they hate themselves. You know what a black man, I was listening to him on YouTube, he said black men are the only ones that marry out their race at a high percentage. Oh my God. Well, I ain't got nothing against integration, what do you call it, interracial marriages. But we happen to have a high number of our black men marrying outside their race. And then after you do marry a European or white person, they still want to control you. Why? Because you're still black. You just keep right on living. You keep right on living. Well, we have covered, I want you to go to the book of Acts, the 26th chapter. Acts, the 26th chapter. Acts, the 17th chapter. Just before I get into something good. Acts 17 chapter and the 26th verse through the 28th verse. And we'll start right there. We're talking about during the 1800s, there was a man named, was it Thomas Edison that invented the light bulb? Yeah. Am I right?
Yes.
Well, really, it wasn't about Thomas Edison. It was about a black man by the name of Louis Latimer. Where's that light bulb, that full bright? Did you put it up?
Where?
Seth, come up here. Come up here, Seth. Real quick light. Hold that light bulb up. Turn around and face the people. Turn around. There you go. Now, Edison had got to a place where there were a lot of men that were inventing light bulbs and working in laboratories trying to invent a light bulb. Edison got to a place where his light bulb would not burn long because he had paper in it. Long come a black man named Louis Latimer. His parents were runaway slaves. Somehow he got educated. See why it's important for black young men to get educated? Get your education so you can function in life. Well, anyway, Edison's light bulb wouldn't burn. It would go out. So what did Mr. Latimer do, Brother Louis Latimer did? He invented what they call a carbon filament. That little old bitty line that goes across there. It's like you can't see them in light bulbs now, but there's that little bitty line in there. And that was what propelled him to help Mr. Edison get the light bulb on the market, was he invented the carbon filament in there to make the light bulb stay on longer. You know, light bulbs so cheap now, if you buy them, they might go out by 2 or 3 weeks. But anyway, but he was the one that invented. They say not only did he invent the light bulb, he had a big portion in that, but he also invented the telephone. See what can happen when you get educated, you educate yourself and you put God first. It don't matter where you come from. His parents were runaway slaves. Look what he did. Inventions and a lot more other things don't come except there are hard times in life. I just hope this next generation, they've been so spoiled, they own computer, they own all this other stuff. I just hope and trust that something good will come out of y'all generation. Hold that light bulb up one more time. There it is right there. So, your people help invent that. See, it's more to it than just learning about certain things. You need to learn about the turn of the century, who invented what, and how it got on the market. George Washington Carver had over 300 uses of a what? Peanut. I said 300. He invented Crayolas. What you call them? Crayolas with the peanut. He invented peanut oil. He invented so many things that come out of that peanut. If he was living right now, he'd probably have a disease for this flu they got.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Thank you for saying. You want that as a present? You can sit down. You take that with you. Give it to Brother Fulbright. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Well, I thought I'd put that in there so that you could learn more about your history. Didn't start in the Bible. It started in the Bible, but it's been going forward ever since. You've just been hoodwinked not to know. Acts 17:26, what does it say? Acts 17, chapter.
And suddenly.
Acts 17:26.
And had made of one blood.
How many bloods?
One.
You and I have the same blood coming out of us like any other race of people. Same blood. I'm A positive. There's some other race that need my blood. You may be O, you may be B. Somebody else needs your blood to match up in case there's an emergency. Any of y'all ever give blood to the Red Cross?
Yeah.
I gave some one time. I haven't given any recently, but you know, I'm kind of funny about needles sticking in my arms and looking at all that blood coming out of me. But anyway, that's okay. It's good if you want to go down there and give your blood. That's fine. Go ahead, read on.
And made of one blood all nations of men.
Out of one blood, all nations. What are nations? Is what?
People.
Did y'all hear me, people?
Yes.
Out of one blood has made everybody. Read on.
Nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth,
God made everybody, whatever race you are, to dwell on the face of this earth as long as he give you the breath to live. Read on. And it was really God's will that we live in peace and harmony and not all this stuff that's going on now. Read on some more.
And has determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation.
And the bounds of their habitation. In other words, God will that we all divide up and we live different places. Our skin color would change. What's wrong with being black?
Nothing.
When I was brought up, it was a curse. Because that's what they taught. All you old black so-and-so, come on here. You're cursed. But now some of us are waking up and find out that black is beautiful.
Yes.
Kinky hair is the same hair that Jesus had.
Yes.
Whoa! I wish my hair would grow out longer. I'd rather have dreadlocks to locks, rather. Read on. What else it say? Is that all of that?
Yes.
27.
Mm-hmm.
That they should seek the Lord.
Uh-huh.
If happily they might feel after him.
That they might seek God. Read on.
And find him.
Uh-huh.
Though he be not far from every one of us.
God is not far from us. He's right at the doors. Wanting everybody to be saved. It's not God's will that everybody, that nobody be lost. It's his will that everybody be saved, but everybody don't want to be saved. Mm-hmm. What good is black history is if you're not saved? Mm-hmm. After black history, you're going to leave this place. You're going to be with God or you're going to be with the devil. So we need to get our priorities right. Mm-hmm. Is that all of that?
28.
Uh-huh.
For in him we live?
For in Christ, in God, we what? Live!
Yeah.
God brought us out. Living. He's defeated death and he wants us to live. Even if you die, if you not die, you just took on another form. You just departed from this life under the sun to another life.
Mm-hmm.
Read on.
And move.
We move. Come on here.
And have our being.
Some of us move fast. Some of us, as we get older, move slower. And have our being. We locate humans by where they live. History verified this. There are different races, there are different cultures, there are different colors of skin, and because that's how we locate one another. Well, look at this chart right here. Well, before I get to the chart, go to the book of Genesis 11 and 11. I think that's what we're doing. 11 and 7, that's where I want you to go. Genesis is mean what? Your genes, your beginnings, your makeup, where you come from. See, if you don't know where you come from, you don't know where you're going. And if you don't get history straight, you're bound to do what? Repeat it again and again and again. My thing is, I think the American Negro is going to repeat history. And that's a bad thing because the history of America is enslavement for black people. Hopefully we learn and have enough education and have enough God in us that we won't have to go that route no more.
Amen.
What does the book of Genesis 11 and 7 say?
Go to.
Uh-huh.
Let us go down and there confound their language.
Let us go down there and confound their language. Mm-hmm.
That they may not understand one another's speech.
That they may not understand one another's speech. Come on.
So the Lord scattered them.
So the Lord did what?
Scattered them abroad.
He scattered them. Why? Because they were building a station down there in Babel. They call it the Tower of Babel. And you know, God had blessed man with pretty good knowledge and understanding, but he was taking it to another level. Nimrod was.
Uh-huh.
History says that he was building not just with brick and mortar, but he was building a space station.
Yeah.
Way back then. They going to the moon. They way out there in space. Well, that's old.
Mm-hmm.
Solomon said what is now has already been before.
Mm-hmm.
So what did God do? He stopped them from building.
Yes.
This station or this tower that they were building. and he confound the language. That's why we got so many languages now. At one time, everybody spoke the same thing. But now we got all kind of languages, don't we? We got German, we got Russian, we got Swahili, we got Spanish, we got, oh my goodness. I'm like everybody else, keep English. I don't want to know, learn no other language. I mean, you know, I'm satisfied with just English. Maybe a little Spanish, a little this and that, but hey, I can only understand people through the process of English. So make English a universal language. Read on, what does it say?
Scattered them abroad from thence upon the face of the earth.
God scattered them after the flood. Y'all with me? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
After the flood.
Right.
And God seen that man wasn't going to do right. Mm-hmm. So what did he do? He scattered us. Mm-hmm. Since y'all want to build a space station and try to defy me, try to be God yourself, I'm going to scatter you. I'm going to change your language and I'm going to let y'all scatter. What do you mean by scattered? Just go where? Different ways. So when they scattered, when God, the Bible said God did it, didn't it? Didn't God scatter the people?
The Lord scattered.
The Lord, Yahweh, scattered the folk, the people. And when they went to different places, there was a change in their physical makeup. Well, this chart here talks about the sons of Noah. Now, Ham and Shem, they stayed there. They left Babel, Iraq, Iran, or wherever that could be, Iraq, and they went back to Africa, a deeper part in Africa, where it's real what? Hot. And Japheth, the son, one of the sons, the oldest son, or middle son, he went toward Europe and the Caucasian Mountains, where it's cold. I don't like cold weather. I like warm weather just as it is now.
Right.
Not too hot, not too cold.
Wow.
But that's me.
Yes.
Some folk like cold weather. I don't like it too hot either. But anyway, as Japheth migrated toward the Caucasian Mountains up around Russia, parts way up in Turkey, his skin changed. He started off being black and brown, and when he lived over hundreds of years, he turned white.
Yeah.
Well, you go stay in a hot, in a cold climate, your skin color gonna change too over a number of years.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not gonna go there now about being cursed. We'll say that for later on, but we're gonna stick with the good. We're going to say that we all, that Japheth migrated toward Europe and the Caucasian Mountains, and his skin color over a period of time became white. Mm-hmm. We was once all here, dark brown, black, because black people come in so many shades of brown. But as we got out of the sun, see, before Noah, or during the time of Noah, everybody was saying, same shade, black and color. That was the norm. But this is not the norm. He had blonde hair, and he had to adapt to the sun's rays. His eyes, some of them came blue. See, they're not gonna teach you this in no church, no, very little in education they're gonna teach you that. But the anthropologists, they all verify this. Hey, Hitler even knew this. People scared to talk on this because they scared that you will rock the foundation of American religion. We have religion, but you can't rock the Bible because the Word of God is true. Huh?
Yeah.
Well, since we in so much over in America, I made a survey. Okay, I started off with the Jehovah Witness, okay? And they portray Jesus as a what? What kind of man?
No white son.
What is that? Is he white? Is he black?
You can't see it.
Y'all can't see it? Can you see that now?
Yeah.
Yes.
All in the watchtower, he's portrayed as a white man.
Yes.
Well, I stopped there. Okay, okay. Well, I went to the Mormons. I said, let's see what the Mormons say. Oh, by the way, the Mormons say that you are, black people are cursed. They teach that in their literature. That you're cursed, the Nephites and the Lamanites, however they got it figured out. But they say that because God cursed them, they all turned black. It's in the Bible. It's in the Book of Mormon. You need to read your Book of Mormon. So when they come knock on your door, you can talk to them.
Hmm.
That's your Mormon. My question is, where are you at?
Nowhere.
Hey, even the lamb is white. The lamb that Jesus was, the original one was black, a black lamb.
Huh.
Oh my God. Can you see the brainwashing?
Yes.
Oh,
of black people? And you know what? We join. Notice I said join. Because if you've really been born again, you ain't getting nothing like that. Not only that, but the Seventh-day Adventists. I've been to their seminars. And they portray Jesus as a, they got a big picture of him, a Caucasian. My question is, if we're such a multicultural society and everybody's equal, why come they can't make him black? Come on, y'all, and think. Why come they can't make him black to look like me or you? And how come they can't put a patch of wool, a big woolly head man up there like the Bible says? Something to think about. Not only that, but the Catholic Church. Have they had any black popes in the last 200 years? And black people are Catholic. I'm not condemning them. Oh. I'm taking a step further. What about the Baptists? I went to a Baptist church before I walked in. It was a great big old picture. A Baptist black church. That's what I seen when I walked in the door.
Oh my God.
Well, I was in the same trap because I didn't know. I go in there, oh yeah, that's Jesus, man. Is it? Carter J. Woodson said, the problem with the American Negro is his miseducation about himself, about the Bible, and about everything else. We come from a pyramid, now we live in the ghetto. Well, the Methodist people, they may have some sense. The AME, they know Jesus was a man of color. Because Richard Allen told him, they told him back in the 17th century to get up off his knees and get out of this church. And that's where your AME started. Well, he was forced to get up and get out because he was black. See, history is nothing to make you shout. You shout after you learn your history.
Amen.
And after you learn your history, you learn that you're free.
Amen.
How many people you know this information? Well, hey, I don't blame these people. I blame you because you ain't got enough ingenuity to read about your history.
That's right.
Because you just like them. It's not important. Then first thing we say, the question is, what difference do it make?
Everything.
The question should be, why have you and I been whitewashed?
Right.
Let me read a little bit more history here. Y'all still with me?
Yes.
Eastward, the ark rested on Mount Ararat with Noah and his three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. All human life after the flood is credited to Noah's family. His three sons are responsible for the fathers of all nations, the producers of all races.
Yes.
Someone go to Genesis 9:18 real quick. Genesis 9:18 and the 19th verse.
Okay.
We're still in the book of Genesis. We come from the New Testament back to the Old. What does Genesis 9:18?
And the sons of Noah
uh-huh.
that went forth. forth of the ark were Shem.
Shem.
And Ham.
Ham.
And Japheth.
And Japheth.
And Ham is the father of Canaan.
And Ham is the father of Canaan. If Canaan was cursed, man, he was the most ingenious son it was. Because God gave the land of Canaan to the sons of Shem. When they got over there, they were at such an advanced society, they had already built homes. They already had a plumbing system. They already were efficient in mathematics and agriculture. They were already there. Because how can you get an apple, a grape, to grow the size of an apple if you don't know something about science and agriculture? In Genesis 11:7, go to Genesis 11:7. I think I just read that, didn't I?
Yes.
Okay, we'll hold it. That's about confounding the language, okay. In Genesis 11:7, God confounded their language, which compelled them to separate according to Noah's sons. Well, they didn't separate because of race. They separated because they couldn't understand one another. I'm telling you to give me a brick, and you saying give me some sheetrock. Well, that's mass confusion. I hand you this and you get up there, man, I didn't tell you to give me that. Now, well, I don't even know what he's saying. That's why they call it the Tower of Babel, because it's a tower of what? Confusion. Most people I know, black or white, they confused now. not going back to the Tower of Babel, they just confused with life and the will of God. Well, so much for that. Come on, that's a whole different thing. By this act, new nations were formed. Jacob and his family traveled.
Thank you, friends, for joining us this Sunday. Tune in next Sunday for more good gospel teaching and preaching. I want to pray for you. If you're sick, if you're afflicted, or whatever you're going through, I know that God will make a way for you and bring you out of whatever trouble you're in. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to touch my people. I ask you to deliver them and set them free. Give them what they need. Touch those that are sick from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. I heard you say that with your stripes we're healed. Amen.